Here we are filming this morning. This is Mark Stothard. I'm just filming a little bit here in the dark to show you that the insanity begins quite early here.
For this video, you're going to need a little context. What you're seeing was filmed by my friend Mark Stothard back in 1994. This tape experienced an underground sort of fame in New York's Oak Orchard Creek. To see it, you'd visit Mark at his home on the banks of the Oak, and he'd play it on his VCR for you. Mark had a lot of visitors. While you were treated to these scenes of slashing and pounding and screaming and clubbing, Mark would give you, in person, a hilarious, sarcastic, running commentary of the whole thing.
We don't know if it's a trout or not. These guys couldn't identify a porpoise.
He'd point out the most egregious of the crimes against nature, making sure you didn't miss them while you watched, incredulous at the melee that the DEC allowed to happen.
Or fish struggling with a big hook in its side. Many consider that a great game fish. Can't believe this goes on here.
Up until about 1995, in New York State, you were allowed to catch spawning Chinook salmon by snagging them.
Nice hook in the side, in the belly.
Guys would take a heavily weighted treble hook, tie it to thick line strung through a pool cue rod, and jerk it through the water to try and snatch a fish in the side.
There you go. There, they double hook them. You have to do that. They only got 40, 50, 100 pound test.
The state allowed this at the beginning of the salmon stocking program in the late 60s because it was believed that you couldn't get a spawning salmon to bite. The result was that New York spawned an entire generation of guys that never tried to catch a fish any other way. Mark was a real-life trout bum, so he fished the entire spring and fall runs for all that time. Mark was appalled by the behavior that legalized snagging brought out in people. There was a strong lobby to ban the practice in the early 90s.
There you go. Nice cast.
Oh, man, Derek. Oh, I got it right where you go. Got it in your mouth. Oh, man.
Really, John?
Geez, what a novel idea. A hook in the fish's mouth. Looks like a nice coal hole.
Boy, that was a big one.
No, we can't tell. No, it's a Chinook.
I'd be hitting on the head.
Understandable. Build a stone wall around them. There you go. That's a unique. I haven't seen that yet. All right. This guy's going to be an engineer. You can hear the rustlings of my partner. There he is. The double C. Carl Coleman. Noted fly tire and fisherman.
Carl Coleman, a prominent Rochester fly shop owner, gave Mark a camcorder and commissioned him to film what went on down there. This tape could be sent to Albany to appeal to lawmakers to put an end to the ravaging of a world-class fishery. It worked.
Well, he's teaching a little kid how to do it. That's a nice thing to teach the children. He's a cute little kid anyway. What happens is they all come up during the night, and then first thing in the morning, they try to make it out of here because of everybody stomping around in them. The fish head all downstream trying to escape. A few of them do. Usually by 9 o'clock, the stream is pretty well cleaned out. The survivors are cowering under a rock somewhere, making it very hard for a traditional fisherman to catch anything. When all the browns finally do get in here, it's going to be murder. I don't think I'd want my little kid hanging around with a bunch of swinging hooks like that. School's making a break for it. Fish don't even want to be in this river.
Mark lived on the river. He used to tell me that he could be in his house and know when a fresh run of salmon had moved up because it sounded like a soccer stadium down there.
Okay, he's got some pretty heavy line on there. It's planer board line. I think it's about a 180-pound test. That ought to work. Here we have Mr. and Mrs. Salmon. What do you think about this snagging business, Mr. Salmon?
Well, I'm pretty angry. I booked this trip 4 years ago with the DEC out of Altmar. I'd like to get my money back.
Ooh, that one's got a big hole. Isn't that a pretty sore? Good morning. This is Mark Stothard. It's Wednesday, October 19th. I'm filming the snaggers again. Good sized run of fish came up yesterday. I guess they haven't heard about it yet. There's not a lot of them, but it doesn't take a lot of those people to disrupt the fishing. And there you go. Should be all done right now. That's the limit. Here we have a technique called lifting, where they dress up like fishermen and give it a yank. There, missed. Throw it in. There, yank. Missed. Blind snagging. He doesn't care what he hooks, as long as he hooks something. The lead hitting the water scares the fish quite badly. Makes it real tough for a regular fisherman. Normally they're shoulder to shoulder here, but there's not too many guys today. He's got one. Classic lifters. Plunk and lift. Plunk and lift.
Good, and she goes. can roll over, I can hit her in the head now.
Good job. Watch that fish. Looks like he didn't get him. Too bad. Here he comes back. That probably wouldn't disturb the fish. They double hooked them. Tag team. Get them, boys. There goes the stopper. Oh boy, look out. Here he comes. Being careful of the trout today. Maybe it's because there's two people standing there with a camera. There's a brown trout he just snagged. I think it's a trout. Looks like it. Yep, just left it there. And here he comes now. Sees the camera. We got a brown trout. We snagged him. That's several he's snagged so far. There you go. Well, that one's had it. Nice snag hook on the end. There he goes. Back for another. He's got another brown trout.
This is another brown trout.
He's dragging it up. He won't stop though. He's gonna, he'll catch 100 of them. There goes another one.
Look at the snag coming out of that fish. Puts the fish back.
Nice hole in it. Too late now.
That fish will die in probably 2 weeks.
Not dead yet, but it will be. Back for another. Here's a guy who's caught a brown trout legally. Like you're supposed to. As you can see, the fly in its mouth. Nice fish. Take a picture.
Careful you leave the fish back in the water.
The hook is being careful to keep it in the water.
There's quite a bit of difference in the care these fly fishermen are showing the fish, isn't there?
There he goes. To fight again another day.
There he is. Got another one. I don't know what it is. Is it a trout?
Brown trout.
Yep, he's got another brown trout.
Look at that.
You'd think after a while he'd stop doing that. Yep. There's a big hook in him. That's nice. Isn't it beautiful? That fish is all done.
Occasional fish, uh-huh.
Yep. That guy's caught a dozen of them. Well, at least he knows the difference. He must have went to college for biology. He's got another one. I don't know what it is. Nice trout. Geez, that's quite a few trout for this guy. There it goes. He's trying to escape. Oh, man, the rod broke. Yeah, but you don't need a rod when you're doing that. You can just... Get him, boys. Get him. There you go. They got a double hook into him.
I think I've never seen it before.
Oh, really?
There you go. Maybe they could use another hook into it.
Oh, yeah, I see the guy broke his rod and break his wheels, just fall in the water, get ringing wet. Oh, my, I tell you.